to.
I
little man. Put that shit in my hand. If that money doesn't show, then you owe me, owe me, oh. My jungle love, yeah. Oh, we, oh, we, oh. I think I wanna know you, know ya. Yeah, what?
Then what are you singing?
You don't know jungle love? That shit is the mad notes. Written by God herself and handed down to the greatest band in the world. The motherfucking time.
And the guys in that Prince movie?
Yeah, Purple Rain.
That shit was so gay. Fucking 80s style.
Eddie, you never say no kind word about the time. Me and Selma model my whole fucking life's around Morris Tantrum. I'm a smooth kid who loves the pussy. And tell me here's my black man, sir. What?
What'd I tell you two about dealing in front of the store? And drop the kid and pedal your wares someplace else, bird boy. And for the record, the time sucked ass.
Yo, you guys want to hear something fucked up about him and that quick stop, boy?
Were you supposed to be here tonight? Don't get me started.
Hey, can't we do something about those two stoners hanging around outside the store all the time?
Why? What'd they do now?
I'm trying to watch Clash of the Titans, and all I can hear is those two screaming about Morris Day at the top of their lungs.
I thought the fat one didn't really talk that much.
What, am I producing an A&E biography about him?
Two packs of wraps. Yo, how was the service?
What service?
The one at the Unitarian Church last week where you two got married to each other.
What the hell are you talking about?
Jay said you guys had a Star Wars themed wedding and you tied the knot just like stormtroopers. And he says you're the bitch and you're the butch.
I'm the bitch?
Yeah, that's the way I'd see it.
Will you shut up?
Grayson, I miss you so much. You don't realize how much I miss you, but I do. Grayson, I'm sorry that you got killed by Mr. Anonymous. I'm sorry that I had to kill you just to be Mr. Anonymous. To find out the truth about this is bullshit. It's gotten too far. Grayson, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for all I've done. I won't ever do it again. I regret what I did was wrong. I realize it led me nowhere. Grayson, I know that you always used to sing the song with me before. You always used to sing the song when we first met you. And I know this has been a really hard time for you since your girlfriend has broken up with you. Since you always talk, you always try to make it fun by being a comedian. You know, not saying anything about your ex-girlfriend because you're a comedian and you want to make a joke out of it. You don't want to take everything so serious. But I know it's not a joke to you and it's serious that your ex-girlfriend broke up with you. And I know it's been a hard time. And ever since I met you, since day one, you were the funniest guy and hilarious guy I ever met in my life. And I wouldn't do the world. I wouldn't give up the world for you. Grayson, you used to play the song all the time. And now it's time to play it again. We'll always play the song, no matter what. Alright, Grayson, if you're hearing this, this is the last song we're ever gonna play. Please, Grayson, come back. Another reason you cry. Come on, Dyson. Please. I know you're alive. Dyson. The hell? Dyson. What in the... Dyson. I'm here. I'm here. I promise. In the kitchen. I'm here. I'm in. Open the closet. Someone has to be playing a prank on me. You got 30 more minutes and you gotta get up, okay? Almost 8 o'clock. You gotta get up and ready for your doctor's appointment. Can't believe this. Like I said, the first time that Vincent met Dyson, they knew they were going to be together. But now he misses them to this day. He still died because of what he did to his own friend. That would have made him pay for what he did. Yes, just so you know, guys, he's not really dead. Dyson is not really dead because he's just a puppet in his own, and he's played by Rachmaninoff. So he's not going to die in the next scene. He will be alive. In this scene, though, it's acting like he's dead. So just so you know. Alright.